How have you witnessed the impact of global warming firsthand?
Yeah, well, in a lot of the places we've traveled, we've seen, I guess, the environment change over the years we've been there. I think one of the most poignant moments for me was up in the Canadian Arctic, working with these Inuit hunters, who are very, very traditional hunters, covered in their seal skins, and they've got their harpoons. So these Inuit go out on the sea ice to hunt seals every spring. And I remember standing on this pebbly beach, looking out at this dark Arctic Ocean, just water in front of us, with this Inuit hunter. And he was standing there with these big furry boots on and his spear. And he just looked at me and he said, "You know, every year for the last 40 years, on this day, I've stood out onto ice and walked out and gone hunting on ice across the horizon." And we just stood down, we're looking at his boots with these waves lapping at the fur. And it just was the most heartbreaking moment to think that his world, his life had changed so much that all of a sudden there was just no ice for him to go and hunt on. And that wasn't something that was a graph or something abstract or scientific data. It was somebody's real experience. And I think those stories from the field, the people who say, "Well, yeah, the ice used to be here and now it's gone there," those are the most powerful. You really feel that, because that person is telling you that it's changed in the time they've lived there.
That is absolutely heartbreaking. I think it's so easy for us to sit here in our, nice safe homes and look outside and go, "Oh, isn't it bad? Isn't climate change bad?" But these people are living it, and the actions that we are making are directly impacting them. It's so easy for people to just completely separate themselves from it. So, following on from that, what is the biggest challenge we must overcome to be more sustainable?
It's a really tricky question. We've got a lot of work to do as humans. I think the place that I see making the most amount of effort is really taking on corporations and politics, where the real power is. I think for a while now we've slightly been not sold a con, but I think this focus on individualism has been part of the neoliberal ideal, and I think it's really made us that whole adage of think globally, act locally, has made people focus on recycling in the home. And there's always this pressure as to what can I do? What can I do? I should be recycling my cups or recycling my newspapers. And I sometimes do this experiment with an audience where I try to calculate how much time people spend recycling at home. How much time does your family spend? And people kind of think about the newspapers or the cups or the minutes, and we add the minutes to the hours and the days, and we work out how much time in a year the average home spends recycling. And then I say, "Well, how many minutes did anyone in your family spend writing to an MP?" And most people look around blankly. "And how many minutes did anyone spend writing to a corporation and asking them to change their behavior?" And again, most people look around blankly. And that, for me, is the change that I'd really love to see us put more effort into. We live in a world now where social media gives us incredible amount of power. And we can have direct conversations with corporations and ask them to behave better, and especially celebrate corporations that are behaving better. It doesn't have to be negative, it's not a shame game. But for instance, you can go to your local coffee shop, and if it's the one that stops selling single-use cups for the first time, tweet them directly or get on social media and just thank them. And I once had someone in an audience say, "Oh, but I don't have many followers." And you know what? It doesn't matter, because if you tweet and tag that coffee shop, they will retweet that supportive tweet to all of their followers, and it can spiral and go viral. And so I think people really underestimate the power that we have with tools like social media. It really is the most powerful way that we can get things changed. And I like to think of things like the Blue Planet 2 plastic effect as being something that has been positive in recent memory. Because I think there's a lot of doom and gloom out there about the environment, and to be honest, there are a lot of bad news stories. But I like to focus on the plastics as just a small example of how quickly humans can change. I think 10 years ago, if I went into a bar and you gave me a gin and tonic and there was a straw in it, I wouldn't have thought twice about it. And yet now, if you put a straw in my plastic straw in my gin and tonic, I'd be looking around thinking, God, where are the cameras? I'm going to hell. I'm going to hell. And I think that is incredible how that change has happened just in the last 5 or 10 years. And it shows you how quickly humans can change as a species. Another example is fossil fuel cars. I think 10 years ago, we might have debated what generation would still be driving fossil fuel cars. I think at this current day, you wouldn't find a single oil company executive who would argue that their grandkids are going to be driving fossil fuel cars. We know that they will be over. We just know it. And that acceptance is wonderful. So we should hold on to the fact that humans are an incredibly adaptable species. We can make changes quite quickly when we put our minds to it. And so I like to, you know, to hold on to those examples moving forward.
Yeah, that's incredible. And so much hope, which I think is really important. You're right, the spending power of humans putting your money into companies that are going to really give back to the planet is so important. But at the same time, companies, they can't greenwash us. You know, they can't put their products in a brown cardboard box with a green font and expect us to be okay with that. They've really got to show down the supply chain that they are as sustainable as possible.
Yeah, yeah. And it's about the conversations. That's the big thing. I think it's about, you know, people amplifying those conversations. And, you know, I've talked to school groups and universities and corporations, and it's amazing watching the younger generation, how proactive they get in writing to the local businesses and saying, hey, we'd like to see you doing a bit more of this or a little less of that. And you know, there's been some incredible examples of us changing major corporate behavior through pressure exerted in social media, which is fantastic.